Good Saturday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen, Onek with a quick weather update for you just past the top of the hour. We've got some very chilly conditions tonight. More frost is going to be possible across the Mid-South, so if you have plants or pets outside, please make certain they're taken care of. Should be seeing the International Space Station passing overhead here in just a little bit less than half an hour on the northern horizon. We'll talk more about that online in just a little bit. If you've never joined us here before, welcome to our online video weather blog, Weather Overtime. This is where we give you a little bit more information about what's going on in the Mid-South where it comes to weather across the area, keeping you updated as to what's happening out there. If you have any questions about the forecast in the Mid-South, that's East Arkansas, North Mississippi, and West Tennessee, we'd be glad to do our best to answer your questions about that. If you live outside the area, we'll do our best to get to those questions, but if you have questions about the forecast in Barrow, Alaska, it might take us a little while longer to get to that. Plus, we got a lot of other stuff to talk about as well, so definitely want to stay tuned for more there. Drop your locations and whatever weather reports you've got out there, your high temperature today, the current temperature, rainfall amounts, and the rain gauge, whatever's going on, we'd like to hear about it, so give us a weather report and a city, state. Just give us your general location. You don't need to give us your mailing address. That's very nice of you, but you don't have to do that, so thank you very much on that one. And again, don't forget that if you've got weather pictures, we'd love to share them. We'll show them to you, a few of them at least, coming up here in just a little bit. Just remember to tweet them to me at aonic_WREG3 or on my main Facebook page. You can find me on all these social media sections. If you've never been here before, welcome to the show. Again, down in the blue bar at the bottom of your screen, got, again, the forecast rolling on by, which you can also pick up the 7-day forecast available here at WREG.com/weather to keep you updated with what's going on. Keeping you updated on seismic events, it's not exactly weather, but we do have, again, a little bit of some activity to talk about where it comes to earthquakes. The United States Geological Survey and our own Center for Earthquake Research and Information at the University of Memphis picking up a minor earthquake this afternoon, 2.3 just around Blytheville and just before 1 o'clock this afternoon. We've already posted information about this on our Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram pages. And if you felt this in any way, anything the way of stuff shaking in your house or just feeling, again, maybe your dogs, your cats behaving weird, the United States Geological Survey and SERI would like to know more about it. And you can fill out a Did You Feel It earthquake report, all available, again, into and around the area for more details as to what's going on with this earthquake situation. The more people that report what they felt, the more seismologists, graduate students, professors can study what was felt and where and study how that earthquake energy was transmitted around the area. It was a decently small one, but some of you might have still felt that. So if you did, please check out the information on my web pages and you can find more details there. From our tower cam, beautiful sunset tonight looking back toward West Memphis and the lights of Big River Crossing lit up doing their top of the hour animated show. Again, beautiful evening for a stroll downtown. Little bit on the brisk side, though. We'll get to those temperatures coming up in just a little bit. Nice sky show going on for this afternoon and into this evening. Let me see if we have that. Okay, apparently we don't. If you go out and take a look to the west, you can see bright planet out there, that bright point of light right above the horizon is the planet Venus. Very easy to take a look at for tonight, so a nice little sky show going on for you this evening. And again, the International Space Station passing over the northern horizon at a little bit after 8:30. We'll see if we can bring you more about that on social media in just a little while. What we had in the way of storms from this morning, the snow showers and everything else passing on through the area. Janet Jackson enjoying the cold weather. You are in almost a class by yourself. There's a lot of other people not enjoying the colder weather on there. And if you're enjoying it, hey, great. Post that in the comments section, too. I'd love to hear some of the warmer weather comments out there, like Paulette Morrow wishing for warm weather again, 42 in New Bern, Tennessee. Thank you very much for that one and everybody else checking in for right now. Sherry Sunshine, 87 degrees, partly cloudy with a 60% chance of rain. Doesn't sound like my forecast for tonight, but thank you for sharing that one from wherever you may be having to check in on from for right now. Jazzy Boss, how am I? I could use a root beer. Got a little bit of a dry throat, but other than that, doing quite nicely. Thank you very much, and thanks to everyone else for checking on in for the time being. Now, what's left of the moisture? It's over Alabama. Few areas of sprinkles around Columbus, Louisville, Meridian in Mississippi, but that's all heading away as drier air chases all this stuff on off to the south and to the east, and even some very light snow showers. As you see, the pink pick up there. The green indicates rainfall, cold enough right now for some rain mixed with snow just north of Birmingham and heading down toward west central parts of Georgia for tonight. But that's, again, moving out, not a threat for us. What is a problem for tonight is the temperatures. With these clouds out there this morning, the temperatures were actually pretty stable, believe it or not. But once those clouds begin to part, that allows the heat down toward the surface to radiate upwards, and the temperatures cool off very rapidly. So what we've got for tonight is a good possibility of a hard freeze. So if you have any plants outdoors you want to protect, bring them in. Cover them up. If you have pets outside, please make certain that they are well protected. Remember that if they don't have adequate shelter, that could be considered animal neglect, and that's a misdemeanor crime in all 50 states, so please keep that in mind. And again, might want to leave the water taps dripping in your pipes tonight, a little bit of warm water going on through there. Yes, that's going to cost you a little bit of money, not much, but a little bit, but it's going to be paling in comparison to what happens if your pipes burst. So tonight would be a good idea to open the cabinets, let the heat from the kitchen get in that under sink area, and again, leave the hot water dripping in your faucets just to be on the safe side to make certain that those don't freeze up overnight. Can happen. It's not likely, again, with temperatures again like this, but it is at least possible. So please remember that. These are some of the warmest numbers around the Mid-South on live real-time WeatherNet 3. If you'd like to get this information and these stations on your computer, go to this website address and you can find out a lot more. Wind chills, the winds are dying down, but we still have wind chills in the upper 20s to the lower 30s, so just a little bit on the chilly side there. Sissy Neil Jernigan didn't feel the earthquake in Dyersburg. Okay, very good. Thank you very much. If anybody did feel it around that area, again, we're talking about the earthquake today in and around Blytheville. Wasn't much. It was a 2.3 for those of you who are just checking in. But if you felt anything around that area, follow the links that we have, again, at WREG.com/weather, and we'll give you an idea as to where you can go to report what you felt on that. Now, tonight, again, let's see, Henderson, Tennessee, 37.9. Very accurate temperature there. Celia Horton Lair, thank you very much for joining us for this evening. Jane Alsop, just wait, in a couple of months we will be wanting cooler weather. No question about that. I've got the feeling that the first 90 is not too far away into the course of the next several weeks out there. Jeff Smith didn't feel the earthquake, but definitely felt the cold. Thank you very much. Cindy Salinas, hope you get to feeling better. You're feeling sick. This weather is crazy, or variety as we call it, so thank you very much for checking in there. 29 in Oxford, Pete Trussell, not too far away from that actually on the wind chill side of things. Now through tonight, again, those clouds are gone, winds out of the north, we should be seeing clearer skies. We should actually see some pretty good sunrise shots tomorrow. Got some great sunset shots tonight. If you've got them, we'll show you where to send those in just a little bit. Through tomorrow, again, more clouds start to make their way through as we go into the afternoon, and temperatures much warmer than what they were today. Today, about 25 degrees colder than what we usually see at this time of the year, so that gives you an idea as to how powerful that cold front was coming on through the area. Now, toward tomorrow night and into very early Monday, right around rush hour, we could see the possibility of a few sprinkles. Doesn't look like much right now according to this forecast model, but I would keep an eye out for the possibility of, again, some of those showers out there. Lee Pipkins, what about Raymer, Tennessee? Everything we've just said out there, again, 40s and 50s for highs tomorrow. Chances of rain as we go into Monday, so thank you very much for that. Rebecca Stanford Mayo, New Albany, 36 degrees. Thank you very much for that weather report there. Much warmer tomorrow, almost by about a category or so, as we see a few showers possible around dinner time and overnight. Could stick around for Monday morning, so I would tune in for Todd Demers' forecast on Daybreak Monday. And unfortunately, it looks like Corey Ventura will probably have a lot more to talk about. Again, rain and driving in this area seems to not mix well, so we'll see how well that turns out with those showers around. Now, those should be clearing out throughout the rest of the day. Much milder on the temperatures coming on through, and we should see a bit of a drop in the temperatures after this latest system giving us that rainfall passes on through the area, but mainly clear skies toward about Tuesday evening. Now, we did not have this in the forecast this morning if you were watching on Daybreak, so we do see some thunderstorms possible Friday into Saturday. In between here and there, we've got some dry conditions. No rainfall for several days, so that looks pretty good. And temperatures, again, very much on the mild side, back into the mid to upper 70s or so for the time being at this point. Sissy Neil Jernigan, where did that one quote go? 36 degrees right now, feels like 36 in Dyersburg, and going to get colder. Tonight it's going to be cold, yeah, no question about that, but at least we warm up over the course of the next couple of days, so that's looking pretty good. Burt Bishop, 37, and holding steady in Bolivar. Thank you very much for that. Mike Hawkins, thanks a lot for dropping on through from around the area of West Memphis, 37 degrees at this point in time. And thanks a lot to everybody for checking in. Feels like 25 right now. Lee Pipkins, thank you very much for that one. Elaine Roach, how about Nesbitt, Mississippi weather? Pretty much exactly the same as what you're looking at here. Again, temperatures warming up over the next few days. Chance of showers tomorrow night and into Monday, and then some thunderstorms toward about the end of the week. 10-day forecast going even farther. Again, showing those thunderstorms leaving the area. A little cooler by next Sunday. Not much, but just a little bit. And then back in the upper 70s as we go toward next Monday, and then cooling off again by Tuesday with a chance of a sprinkle possible in there, and that should be just about it. Thanking Mark McKeel for 8299, Mark McKee 8299, thank you very much for the somewhat humorous picture of some frigidarious hail reported in and around Germantown a couple of days ago, looking remarkably like the ice cubes that I get in my freezer. So thank you very much for that little bit of weather humor. Louis Haskett, Scruff the weather dog, Skip the weather pup, staying indoors. Scruff outside, wondering what all this white stuff was from this morning in northeast Arkansas. So thank you very much for that one there. And a little bit earlier this week, a little bit of sunshine, a little bit nicer conditions out there. James R. Gulledge, one of our frequent contributors here on our Weather Picks segment from around Humboldt, Tennessee, getting some nicer conditions showing up here. So looking pretty good in and around Humboldt into around the area. Happy early birthday to Bozo Woolfolk from checking in from Senatobia. Going to be fairly nice on Monday, maybe a sprinkle early, but that's really going to be about all we've got. If you've got pictures, I want to see them so we can feature them on our Weather Picks segment, but if you don't send them in, I can't give them a shot and show them to everybody, and my psychic power is a little bit below par at this point, so mentally I can't just project them here, so you have to step up and send them. So if you've got them, send them along to me, Aonic_WREG3, Aonic no underscore necessary, WREG3 on Instagram, and on my main Facebook page, Austen Onek, WREG as well. Last two Skywarn Spotter meetings coming up for the winter and spring semester. This Tuesday, this one was postponed from last week because of the severe weather in and around Brighton, Tennessee on Highway 51 South at the Tipton County Emergency Operations Center. That'll be Tuesday, April 10th at 6:30 p.m. Also postponed from an earlier date, Wednesday, April 18th, Helena, West Helena, Arkansas in Phillips County at the Phillips Community College Bonner Student Center, Wednesday, April 18th at 6:30 p.m. These Skywarn meetings teach you more about what you need to look for before, during, and after severe weather. And a very nice thing to have around is when you use one of these things to call in your information to the National Weather Service about what you as a spotter are seeing out there. You can help save lives. So something to consider. Take one of these courses if you can make it to these. There'll be more coming up in the fall and early winter, which is one of our more powerful severe weather seasons. Or you can take the information online. If you'd like to know more, email me at austen.onek@wreg.com to find out more about where that course is located from. Join me in just about 15 minutes or so on my Facebook page. We'll take a look at weather, where the troops are. If you have friends, loved ones serving in the United States military all around the world, we'll take a look at some of the various locations out there, what the weather's doing, kind of wintry in some places, very hot in others, rather tropical in some places. We'll tell you more about that in a quick check of weather where the troops are. It's just our little salute to everybody serving on the home front and for all those who are wearing the uniform of our country to say thanks. So stick around for more on that coming up into and around the area pretty soon. Mario Chiozza, hope I'm saying that right. Chiozza, are you guys doing weather radios anywhere soon? Unfortunately, not the right station. We don't do that, but they are available at places where electronics are sold. Just pick one up, and you can find out more from the National Weather Service by going to weather.gov and scrolling down to all the menu selections and clicking on weather radios, and you can learn how to program it. You don't have to be woken up for a flood warning that is way outside your county anymore. You can program the radios to wake you up for certain signals. And if you'd like to pick one of those up, I urge you to do so. You should have multiple ways to get severe weather information, and that is a very good way to do it. So wherever electronics are sold around the Mid-South, about $20, $30 bucks life-saving piece of equipment. Hopefully your kid's school, your place of worship, your business has one ready to go just in case there's severe weather out there. So definitely want to pick one of those up if at all possible. Nutbush, begging for a sunny day. Tina Marie, thank you very much for that one. Thank you very much for everybody else for checking in from this evening. And thanks for all the great weather reports out there. Catch my forecast throughout the rest of the weekend. If you're driving around, can't use the phone, can't get it on the computer, Oldies 102.3 and Country 92.5. And we'll keep you updated on the radio throughout the rest of the forecast. We'll be on tonight on News Channel 3 at 10 with an update of all the day's news, weather, and sports. And of course, my forecast update coming up on Periscope and Twitter and my own Facebook page in just about 15 minutes or so. So join me for that. More questions, concerns, ideas, anything you'd like to see on here, please let me know, austen.onek@wreg.com, and we'd love to have you along for the ride. So please let me know what you're thinking, and if there's something we can feature on here, let us know, and we'll see if we can add it to the mix. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, in the WREG News Channel 3 Severe Weather Center studio. Stay tuned for more coming up throughout the rest of the evening and on the rest of the weekend as we go throughout Saturday and Sunday with News Channel 3 on air and online. Thanks for joining us tonight.